Welcome, guys, to the Invicta FC virtual watch along. I am Megan Anderson. I'll be your host for this evening. This is going to be exciting. I am so excited. Bruised is out now on Netflix featuring Halle Berry, also in her directorial debut. I will be joined with our panel tonight. We have Invicta president Shannon Knapp. We have, I know she hates me saying this, women's pioneer Julie Kedzie, also one of the Invicta commentary team and a staple of the Invicta roster. But we have former Invicta athlete Rachel Osovich with us all the way from Hawaii. And we also have current Invicta athlete Paulina Granados, Juliana Miller, and Tanisha Tennant, who is the bantamweight champion. She'll be joining with us, but she's having some technical difficulties. So she will be jumping back on here in a little bit. But what an amazing experience, guys. Bruised is on Netflix, so make sure you queue up your Netflix and make sure you crew up the Bruised movie. We're going to be starting shortly, but what's going to happen and how this is going to run is we are going to have the playtime or the runtime playing on screen during the YouTube chat, and fans, you can ask us questions. What we'll be doing is, you want us to ask a specific question for a specific athlete, just write that athlete's name in there and we will get them to answer that during the movie. So it's kind of going to be interactive, kind of chill with you guys and making sure that we're able to kind of interact and experience this with you as well. But before we do, I'm going to ask a couple of questions to our panel. Shannon, this has been a long time coming. I know we spoke about this opportunity a long time ago. What do you think fans can look forward to most in this movie?
Well, I think the big deal for me is I think everybody's really got to pay attention. There's some real hidden gems in here. You just don't know who you're going to see in the movie because of our posters. So I think that fans should really look at the behind the scenes, like when there's a shot, and just look to see who they can see. I think that's going to be an exciting part of this for the fans.
Julie, this one's for you. You are a part of the movie, which I'm so excited about. This is a huge opportunity. What are you looking forward to most out of this, being that you've been in the movie, haven't seen it yet? So what's one thing that you're looking forward to?
You know, honestly, I've kept myself from learning the plot of this movie, so I don't really know what happened. So I'm actually excited just to see the whole thing and understand what happens. But I have to say, Halle Berry, what an extraordinary athlete, beyond actor and director. And so I'm excited to see her chops. And we've seen it in the John Wick movie, right? We've seen it before. I'm excited to see her MMA chops, like, full force.
Yeah. Rachel, this one is going to be for you. What was your first impression of the trailer, knowing that you've, you know, been through Invicta and you've gone on to different things and different opportunities? Like, how amazing was it for you to see this trailer, and what were your first impressions on it? Rachel? You have to unmute yourself.
So sorry.
You're good.
I was like super joy to see the Invicta logo. I was like, oh my gosh, you know, like I just felt like a sense of pride coming from Invicta and, you know, just seeing what Invicta does for, you know, us female athletes.
Paulina, Juliana, as current Invicta athletes, how exciting was it for you knowing that Invicta as a promotion was going to be featured in this movie about women in MMA? Like, how amazing was that for you guys, as you were kind of living this experience that the movie is kind of about?
I was super excited because I love Halle Berry. And I was like, oh my God, she's going to be like in the cage that I was in. That's like super exciting. So I hope she got a little Firefox in her when she, you know, stepped in that cage. So I don't know. What did you think?
I'm really excited for all the women this is going to motivate. I think we're going to see a whole new flash of women that are like, I saw Halle Berry and Shevchenko fight in there. Like, I think all of our gyms are going to boost up like 10 women. So I'm excited to see like who it's going to bring into the sport. I bet even in Invicta, we're going to see some badass new faces that are just coming out of nowhere. So I'm excited for our sport, really.
Well, guys, we are almost ready to get started. Make sure that you queue up your movie. We're going to be started shortly. Guys, fans, everyone in the YouTube chat. If you want to ask a specific question to a fighter during the movie, just make sure that you type that their name in front and then ask your question, and we'll get them to answer that during the movie. But the total runtime is going to be 2 hours and 12 minutes. And what we're going to be doing is we're going to run a bit of a Q&A at the end as well, and kind of open it up to discussion first, you know, watching the movie, and then we're going to go into our first reactions of the movie. So if you have specific questions after, you can also bring that up then. But guys, we are going to get started. I'm about to start my Netflix, so we're going to have the runtime starting here. I'm going to do a bit of a countdown. Okay, so we're going to go 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 and play. Rachel, I have a question from Daniel Silvera for you. How has your training been since after your bare knuckle FC fight?
Let me unmute. My training has been good. You know, I was actually really busted after bare knuckle. Obviously, it's a lot more damage without gloves. So I kind of hurt my hand. So I had some time off, you know, with punching. And yeah, just staying in shape and being ready for the next call.
That was crazy, that scene where she was getting beat up. I feel like it really feels like that. That was crazy. Although that would hit close to home for me, because I've felt that feeling before. Ugh.
10 out of 10, would not recommend.
Have you guys ever felt like climbing out of the cage?
No.
I would, like, melt out of the cage.
But I have, like, legit, like, being like, hey, like when I broke my nose, I was like, maybe like if I wanted to stop now, like I've done enough, because this hurts so much.
There's the cheese grater thing too. That whole post-fight blues thing, post-career blues thing, this is a real shit. Oh, sorry.
Rachel, I have a question for you. How long was your MMA career? This one's from Rodna RS Skates.
Hey, my MMA career, it's still going as far as I know. I just took some time to do BKFC, and I don't think that takes away from MMA. So, I mean, ever since high school, so it's been like, oh, I don't even want to tell you guys, maybe like 11 years. Yeah, make me feel old. Yeah.
Who told Halle Berry the fighters were toxic as fuck?
Well, it already seems pretty realistic to me, doesn't it?
Shannon, I'm going to pose this question from David Bergen to you. MMA fans generally seem to be a territorial group. Celebs will get booed or no sold when they're on the Jumbotron. How do you think the broader community will embrace Miss Berry / this movie?
You know, I think one thing that really speaks volumes is her passion for the sport and the love of it. I think that anytime, I think we're all skeptical when anybody comes into the sport and is going to shine a light on it. And I think that Hallie really has a deep passion for the sport. I think you've always got to embrace somebody like that. Whether you like the movie or you don't like the movie, you know, you can't take away the fact that she is very, very much supportive of women athletes in the sport, and she wants to shine a positive light.
That would hurt so much.
Okay.
Hey, Gabby Garcia!
I didn't want to be the first one to say it, but that's awesome. I didn't know that was Gabby. I thought it was. Badass.
What do you mean you thought?
Well, they didn't zoom in on her face. It could have been an actor, actress.
Yeah,
actor.
Like, oh, they don't have to.
Jeez.
Look, listen, headbutts. Jacked, okay, man. I've thought about this. Ugh. And who agrees with me? I think that headbutts should be legal on the ground in an MMA fight. Like,
yeah, now that I'm not fighting, heck yeah.
I think it should be legal.
It'd be so fun. And stomps.
Yeah, I rolled up on the scene.
How many people walk around underground fights and pass out business cards, you think? Because I actually think it probably happens a lot more than we would suspect. I should probably stop talking.
At least he's cool.
Cute.
They do have backyard fights on reservations. We call it chicken coops. And now they just pass out Instagrams, but I fought on a chicken coop a few times. I feel like everyone's probably had one chicken coop fight. Like, you know, it's embarrassing, but it's stepping stone. So yeah, I feel like backyard fights are shitty promoters, and it can really be dirty like that.
Back in the day in the Midwest, it was barns.
Didn't
see any chickens though.
My very first dirt fight was in a barn in Oklahoma. It was so cold.
Dirt, shitty warm up, too hot or too cold.
Tanisha, I have a question for you. It's a two-part question. First off, how does it feel to win a world title in only your fifth fight ever? And two, you train at Budokan MMA. What's it like training with Randy Rude Boy Brown?
Yeah, I train at Budokan, just like the name in the movie, which is funny. It feels amazing to win a title after five fights. Yeah, it's been a long journey getting to this point. And yeah, I'm just looking for the future. And working with Randy is great, you know. He's such a great guy, you know, I learned so much from him. And he's been just being a real inspiration in general.
Shannon, this question is for you. We've actually got this one a couple of times. A lot of them, the people in chat are asking when the next Invicta event is going to be announced.
Well, we're going to announce the exact date here very shortly, but I will tell you it's in January. It's the second week in January. We're going to end up on a new day. We've got the date. So the main event, I think people are going to be really happy.
Is it Halle Berry? Is she fighting?
Minor. We only got a one fight deal out of her, Julie.
I know this is maybe a silly thing to ask. What's the name of the actor, the kid? Because he's adorable. Does anybody know off the top of your heads? I'll look it up.
Danny Boyd, maybe? Danny? Boyd.
He is so cute.
Yeah, he's really good. Really good in the movie. Maybe Danny Boyd Jr. or something like that. I'll look.
There are not many actresses who can look that elegant on a toilet. Nicole Kidman does it. Halle Berry does it.
Keep your eyes on the walls.
Paulina, I have a question for you.
Angela's poster. Oh, sorry.
No, you're good. What's the origin of your name, Firefox?
Firefox? Oh, that came from Maury Smith. He's like an old school UFC fighter, but that's actually my first coach's coach. And he started calling me that because I would show up to practice every single morning at like 4 a.m. because he would have like these crazy practices. And I feel like he was trying to get me to like not go because he didn't really train women. And then he just started calling me Firefox. And he said I was feisty and I kept showing up and pissing him off. But I kind of grew on him.
It's like the best story.
Yeah. And I was like, that's a web browser, but I like it. Cool. So yeah, I kept it. So, you know, not every day does like a OG UFC fighter call you a name. So I just kept it and just been rolling with it ever since.
Paulina, I have another question for you. It's been really great for you making a name for yourself, and they see a lot of talent. What achievement do you want to accomplish in Invicta?
Honestly, I really want to at least have a chance at fighting for the Invicta belt. Just that opportunity itself would mean a lot to me. But achieving that and having it, that would be just amazing, and I'd be happy with that.
Rachel, I have a question for you. The Invicta fans miss you. Any chance we will see you back in the Invicta cage?
At this point, who knows? You know, I'm always open to that. I love fighting, so yeah, we'll see.
Julie and Tanisha, since you both were in the movie, I have a question for you guys. Did any of you go to New Jersey for filming, and did you get to sightsee New Jersey or the New York City area?
Yeah, actually Shannon flew me out to be the commentator, the Invicta commentator for the scene. And I did. It was fairly cold in New Jersey. I walked around the boardwalk a little bit, got to meet, you know, some of the cool actors and just kind of get a vibe. I love New Jersey. Are you allowed to love New Jersey? I do love New Jersey. I think it's a cool place.
I went to New Jersey. And I got to hang out on set a little bit and see how everything went down. I actually saw you as well, Julia. You know, I was in the back, but I saw you guys doing your thing. It was cool.
I remember seeing you and then feeling like you were one of the actors and I was mistaking you because I'm an idiot sometimes. And I was all over the place. It was like, oh my God, Halle Berry. And I was just like, oh, I think that's Tanisha, but I'm going to embarrass myself. But yeah, I remember seeing you. I'm weird. When it's not fight week. Actually, during fight week, I'm weird too.
But, I mean, yeah. I was having in the back, so it was all
cool. No, I'm so glad you're in this. This is cool.
But yeah, I was in the hotel a little bit and walking around New Jersey. It was cool. I think it was a little chilly, but yeah, I enjoyed it.
Have any of you ever thrown up from practice before?
Oh, yeah.
Really?
I have terrible habits.
I have not.
No, not me.
I'm pretty sure I've thrown up like almost every Saturday practice because of the Friday nights.
I mean, I try not to eat before practice, so that helps.
See, I have to at least eat something. Otherwise, I feel like I'm dying and I have no energy. But like, it has to be very specific what I eat. Otherwise, like, I will want to feel like I throw up, but I can't throw it up.
Shout out to the fight that's going on there. One of the bloodiest Invicta fights of all time. Nice.
That's another one of those hidden gems. They didn't know they were in it.
That's for Zosa Stolyarenko, yeah. Right?
Yeah.
I want a baby. Shout out to the realistic post-fight training face.
Paulina, I have another question for you. You're still young in your MMA career. Do you think you will stay with Alliance MMA throughout your career? Also, what is it like training with former champs / veterans on the regular?
Repeat the question.
You're good. I said, do you think you're still young in your MMA career? Do you think that you will stay with Alliance MMA? And what is it like training with former champions and veterans on the regular?
Well, thank you for thinking I'm young. That's flattering. I've actually been training at Victory and Atos and kind of been jumping around. Alliance actually closed its doors. But I'm still training with a bunch of really awesome people. I've been training with Andre Galvao and Angelica Galvao, learning jujitsu and stuff from them at Atos. And at Victory, I'm still training with some people from the team. And I still hang out with Angela Hill. So she's still teaching me a thing or two, you know, that's my girl for life.
Shannon, I have a question for you. Will you ever allow knees to the head on a grounded opponent, soccer kicks, foot stomps to the face, like back in the Pride days?
You know, no, because it all goes through the commission. You know, I mean, they don't allow it. So, you know, it's not up to me. But yeah, I'm not a fan of all those things anyway. I don't have a choice. So. I will say, be sure to keep an eye out in these gym scenes. I just saw Deanna Bennett and Karina Rodriguez. Yeah, so keep an eye out.
Rachel, I've got a question for you. What do you think of the Evicta Open scoring?
You know, I'm not actually too familiar with it, so I have to brush up on that. I'll tell you another time.
Rachel, I have a question for you. Are you going to be on another Bare Knuckle card upcoming soon? Tremendous win over Paige, by the way.
Thank you. Thank you. You know, I never really wanted to do Bare Knuckle, but I wanted to fight Paige again. And I wanted to beat her. So that was that. And I was successful with that. They pay really good. So it's really up to that. Like, if they pay me right, we're in negotiations. So we'll see. Maybe ending of January, early February. We'll see if everything works out.
Julie, I have a question for you. How do you feel about Misha Tate fighting again? Have you ever thought about ending retirement?
Well, I mean, she's pretty inspiring, right? Like, it does, like, make me, like, I look at that and I'm just like, oh, man. I got a bone to pick with her because she really revamped her game. I know she was unsuccessful in her last fight and she's, you know, she's made some adjustments because of age and stuff like that. But I have to say, like, I got a bone to pick with her because she really did Misha 2.0. I actually believe it. And I don't know. Like, oh, it's tempting. It's tempting. Yeah. I think I'm better off in the academic world, to be honest. Can I just have like a total feminist moment here? That's what happens when women are in charge of the training and the gym stuff and they take care of the kids. Just saying, throwing that out there. They don't send somebody home because their kid's there. They take care of the kid. Anyway, my little moment.
Shannon, I have a question for you. When was the first Invicta card decimated 550? Became an MMA fan in 2013 and Invicta was already on the scene.
April of 2012. I think it was like April 28, 27, something like that. It's been a while, but yeah, 2012, April. Thanks for being a fan too. Greatly appreciated.
Shannon, another question for you. Going back to Pride FC format where they had 10-minute rounds, has it ever been considered for Invicta at some point?
No. 10 minutes? 10-minute rounds? I mean, it's interesting. And, you know, I was a huge fan of Pride, but yeah. No, once again, it comes back to the commission stuff. Here in the States, it's regulated by the athletic commissions. And I don't know anybody that would allow that yet at this point, but... but it was fun, fun to watch.
You don't give fire air. What are you doing? Shout out to Leonard Cohen.
Shannon, I have a question for you. Have you ever thought of changing the championship belt design?
Yeah, a little. You know, just it's been a while since we've talked about that or thought about it, but yeah. I mean, I'm always interested in ideas. If people have an idea they want to send over, you know, certainly send it. We'll take a look at it. But I am going to brag a little bit because I think our belt is one of the best looking belts in the sport. I can't help it. Yeah. Yeah. Like, I'm going to have to take to brag for a minute. Yeah, I think it's a really nice belt. So.
Would Invicta really use that music though for
her? Music?
Nah. Doesn't look like our promos, does it?
Valentina looks so good.
I mean, is she like not perfect in everything that she does? Like, she is seriously like amazing.
Yeah. Goals. Goals.
Tanisha, I have a question for you from Decimated 550. You have a cool low-key vibe. What are your hobbies when you're not beating up training partners?
My hobbies include taking care of my cats, skateboarding, bike riding, anything like adventurous, outdoors, you know, working out, I guess. That's about it. And right now, actually, I've been jet skiing a lot as well. So that's my another hobby I have.
I never did think about putting alcohol in a spray bottle. That is just brilliant.
How are they gonna know?
I usually do it with coffee cups, you know, like back in the day, I would be like, you know, I'm just drinking coffee, nothing crazy. Spray bottle though, wow.
Can you imagine if someone walked in, probably thinking you're crazy?
Too late for all of us.
Man, fuck people who hurt kids. Oh, sorry for the F-bomb. And their significant others. I should have put that in there too. Those are bad people. This movie's hitting all the levels, right?
All the feels.
Triggered. When are we going to get rid of him? We need to get rid of this guy.
Like yesterday.
I always imagine myself climbing into a movie and beating the shit out of people like that. Oh, I keep swearing.
Paulina, I have a question for you. When is your next fight going to be?
I don't know. I hurt my hand, but it's good now. I don't know if you can see it. It's good now. So hopefully 8 weeks or so, Shannon.
Hint, hint.
Oh, the same car.
Julie, ask the matchmakers, please. That's not a question for me.
I'm not the matchmaker. I'm sorry. I will plead on your behalf, but I'm not. I haven't been since 2016.
Thank you. Put us on the same car.
8 weeks.
Be fun to have like a super card that was like 48 hours long with just everybody. I mean, it wouldn't be fun for the promotion at all, but just to have everybody get
it would
to fight.
Be an absolute nightmare production wise.
Yeah, it would be horrible.
Can you imagine commentating that, Julie? Oh my god.
You just tag team. There's like a couple crews, just tag in, tag out,
sleep out the back.
There's a like movie reviewer in Nashville who was talking about his review of this, and he said what was cool about this is that Halle Berry is more of a grappler than a striker in this movie. It's pretty clear, and that does kind of even things out in a lot of ways, or kind of harkens back to the old Hoist Gracie UFC days of little guy can beat the big guy, even though there's just like theme the entire time about big protects little, but it doesn't mean little can't beat big. So I thought that was a really, really interesting insight.
I also think it's like really impressive on an actress type, you know, standpoint, is that usually the striking is the much easier part to pick up for a movie role. So for her to be predominantly grappler and have all of these kind of techniques that are kind of high level is actually really impressive.
No, I thought that too, as well. It's a lot, you know, easier to pick up the striking, you know, and work your way through that than the ground game by far.
I gotta say, there's some good music choices in this movie and just the way they're presented. It's a good score. If it is the score, I don't know what part is the score and what isn't. I don't know movies enough.
Do y'all know when Cardi B's gonna come on?
Well, wasn't it like the first like all female
hip hop score?
First ever all female movie soundtrack.
Yeah.
No, isn't it like the first hip hop album, like all women album, period, though? I think
actually. I believe it is. I mean, I know for sure that it is definitely the first, you know, with a soundtrack for a movie, but I think you're right. I think it was historic in a couple different ways.
Yeah.
I love how that like feeds into the trend of like the all women promotion that Invicta is. I think that's a really kind of neat touch.
Yeah,
that was sick.
And it's cool because they're all current rappers. Like I heard Sweetie, and I think it was just Bottle. So I'm like, yes, I love all of it. It's like my playlist.
Loads of time.
Loads
of time. Trainers on call 24/7. Right, come here. Sorry. I do something wrong.
Juliana, I have a question for you. What is your song of the moment to motivate you during training?
It's really crazy. I actually don't have one right now because I've been doing a lot of jujitsu competitions, and our coach Richie chooses all the music for our Live Drill Fridays and stuff. And beyond that, I've been working in with some of the girls, but I haven't really chosen much of the soundtrack. But I heard a really old school fun song that I'm definitely going to play for my next walkout. And so I think that I don't want to give it away.
Just fucking say it.
But there's like a Smash Mouth song that I think will be really motivating for me in training. It's so silly and old school, but yeah. I don't know, I'm all over the place. I don't have one specific song for training right now. It's like when I'm in fight camp, my walkout song, that's what I play when I'm struggling or frustrated. I go to cryotherapy and I'm like, need to like zone out my mind. Then I'll play my walkout song. But if I don't necessarily have a fight, there's not like one particular song. Not yet.
Okay, you know something. I spoil you at the top.
Did she just say she pays the rent with her ass and her mouth?
This movie just like leaves no trauma unturned.
They're hitting, wow. Hitting them all. Holy,
I know.
Holy, good Lord.
You know, I heard somebody say that the tone just stays dark. I mean, it's believable, you know?
Fight camps are pretty dark though. You know, you're working four jobs and you got to quit a job, and it's like you can't work a regular 9-to-5 if you're going to train, because the pro classes aren't always just at night, so you got to quit. So you're working side jobs. If you have a child, like most people went through their own childhood trauma, so they're like being crazy while trying to juggle a million things. And I think like fight camp does get dark, especially for gnarly.
Yeah,
and I feel like it really like forces you to like really think about all of that trauma, and it really forces you to like address it, because if you don't address it, it's going to come out in the fight.
Watching her throw out that alcohol was huge to me, because it's like whether it's like marijuana or any of the substances that are so often used when you're in a serious fight camp, I think that's one of the first things is like no more drinking, no more smoking, no more friends. You cut out everyone negative out of your life. If you don't, like you're start to succeed, and it's cool to see her like, you know, going through that. I think every fighter who's ever fought has gone through those things of like cutting ties with something negative, because it's just like ruining their life. I was tearing up. I was like, I don't know.
Same. I was crying.
I said not the only one. I'm just like.
No, I'm right there with you, girl. These mother son scenes are just like,
oh. No. God, that theater scene. Oh my God, when they're just looking, yeah. She's just looking at it. Oh fuck.
That part.
Yeah.
She just wants to make her son proud of her.
I loved her fight with Gabby Garcia.
I feel like she wants to make her proud of her too. That actor, that I forgot his name. I forget everybody's. I'm the worst Hollywood follower ever. I need to like get better at that. But that guy's good.
Huh? This isn't just your shot, Jackie. This is my fucking shot. And all I need from you is the last three rounds and make it look good. Because you ain't even a medic in this class.
Damn.
The last 30 seconds. Miss a day of training again. Get me?
Oh, yeah, so that's what I am.
Yeah.
I'm just a tomato can.
If that isn't motivation, I don't know what is. Like having someone call you a can when you know otherwise, it's like the motivation to prove them wrong is just is so strong.
Welcome to Instagram comments.
Right?
All of our Instagram. Shit.
Yep.
Been there. I don't know if that's something you guys reveal while you're currently fighting, but been there.
I was like sitting in the shower for like 20.
He's sleeping. Yeah. Oh, my wife. He was sitting outside the movie theater at 11 p.m. Someone saw him and brought him here. Boy, he had my napkin in his pocket. I'm taking custody now. Wait, hold on. What?
I don't miss ice baths.
Nope. Can't pay me enough money to get in one of those.
Juliana thinks that they're going to end up dating, maybe.
I think there's a lot that could be said about the lines that are being crossed right here, not because they're both women, but because that's trespass in there.
Fine line.
Fine line.
I think I missed a scene because I thought she was still in the ice bath. That would have been really uncomfortable.
I don't understand why she would do this right before her big fight, though. That's what don't make any sense.
Right?
I mean, you gotta relax somehow.
But what, with your coach?
No, see, that's, yeah, that's not good. Yeah. Oh, don't train on railroad tracks, guys. That's dangerous. I feel like a jerk, but that water could be really polluted. You got to be careful. I mean, it's a really cool scene, though.
Weight cut. Coming up.
I think we've all cried through a weight cut.
This is another heart-wrenching one. Oh.
I don't think I've cried, but like I've had, I to this day, I'm pretty sure I have PTSD from weight cuts, and like I can't sit in a bath. Like it literally gives me anxiety, the idea of just relaxing in a bath. I'm like, nope, I'm good.
I find it really interesting how much it looked like she was in labor right there. Like the labor of what? I'm serious. I think that's a really deliberate choice. Like, oh, headbutt time. Yeah.
It's so. Valentina, I don't think I've ever seen Valentina Shevchenko so worked up before. Like, it's so not her. Like in real life, so it's like I love seeing her. Like so worked up.
She can act. That's awesome.
I'd also like to say the belt in that scene belonged to me, Megan. That's your belt.
I know, right here. This is the actual belt movie. That was in the movie.
Yes.
Okay, real talk. How many of you have gone through these deep like things right before a fight? Like where you just all of a sudden start to take stock of everything in your life? It's happened, it must have happened at least once.
I don't think I've ever gone like super deep. Like I usually try to ignore all of my shit. My foot on the back burner. I'm like, I'll deal with that later.
Same.
Maybe that's how I knew I was going to retire.
I would say any type of relationship drama is definitely bad before. It just like
messes. It's heightened too. It gets real heightened right there. Yeah.
And particularly with the weight cut too, because like you have zero patience when you're cutting weight. Mm-hmm. So like you will say like the first thing that comes to your head with like zero regard to like how they feel about it, because you just don't give a shit. Because you're just like, this is my last focus right now.
I don't know. I've definitely had a relationship where like we were fighting or breaking up, especially mostly amateur, not really in my pro fights. I got smarter, but in my amateur fights, I went out there so crazy. Sometimes I'm like, I was like really mad about the relationship drama and it was negatively deep. And like, I feel like that did come out a little in the cage. Like, now I'm learning, I calmed down a lot, but like part of that like killer was definitely after like a really intense moment and I was so mad. I'm like, I'm gonna kill this girl.
Aren't you glad we have that outlet though? Like I get so happy, I swear I'd be in jail already. Like if I didn't have an outlet to like train and you know, on daily and just like let it out. I wonder how like normal people do. I'm like, what are you doing?
I mean, it definitely helps that you can like go to the gym and like let it out. I mean, like, I guess you would, I don't know, you'd have to find some way. I mean, that's why so many people have fights, because they don't have that outlet to just like go de-stress and just not think about it.
Yeah,
it's nice to get paid for it and not end up arrested for, you know, something dumb. Like now people will try to fight me anywhere outside fighting. I'm like, whoa, I'm not about to pay money to something when I get paid to do this, you know. I'm like, so like, yeah, it's nice definitely to be able to be a killer for a second and not have any repercussions.
Wait, did they have a fight? I totally talked through that and was listening.
I don't know. I was trying to figure that out too. What happened there? Why did she take that bottle? I don't get it.
Oh yeah, she basically said she had to figure out some stuff by herself.
You know? Which I mean, like she does. She really does.
Yeah, but see, you don't fuck your fighter, because you this stuff you just don't.
Yeah.
Because you can't take it personally then.
Oh, look at that cage.
Ah.
Oh, look at that cage. Woo. Look at how many memories have been in that cage. Shannon, this is a question for you. How amazing is it to see the Invicta logo up on a screen like this?
You know, I love it. But you know what? I love it not as much for me as I do for the athletes, past and present, you know, and how exciting and proud I know that they feel right now. So, yeah, you know, and I kept this a secret for a long time.
You really did.
Yeah, I really did. I kept it really, you know, a big secret. So that when it did come out, it would have that impact and that kind of thing. So for me, it's really exciting to watch everybody else be so excited. So I love it that everybody loves it, you know, and that makes them feel proud. And, you know, hopefully it motivates young athletes to look over and say, oh my gosh, that's where I want to be.
I think a lot of us are also so happy to finally see Invicta getting this type of attention and the recognition that we all know is deserved, and it has been deserved for a very long time. So I think it's really cool for a lot of us past and present to kind of see that.
Well, you know, I always say do good work and good stuff happens, you know, and I always make fun of this part because, you know, I knew it was coming out from underneath the UFC Fight Pass deal. It was coming up, all this kind of stuff was coming, and I was like, I need a lifeline, you know, God, universe, send me one. And Halle Berry showed up. So it's always a funny thing.
It's perfect timing.
Yeah, it really was.
Look, who's that? Who was that, Julie?
That was the brilliant Eve Edwards, commentator, UFC fighter extraordinaire. Oh. You know, I don't think I'm actually acting right. This is kind of how I am. I saw a scene of me like doing this. I'm like, yeah, that's That's
pretty accurate. I know.
Go flying out of his chair.
Expressive.
It's hard not to feel it. You know, you just want to. Mm.
I still have my very first pair of Invicta gloves with the Invicta logo on it. I keep them in all of my hand wraps as memorabilia. So like one day I'll like put it in like a shadow box in like a trophy room.
I've kept all my fight trunks to turn into a quilt, but I don't know how to make a quilt. So I just have this like huge load of laundry that I just carry with me from apartment to apartment. Oh, no, oh, those logos.
Isn't it crazy how Valentina is the Invicta champ?
I know.
Was it Casey Layden said, so every UFC champion has come from Invicta then?
Yeah.
Oh my, yeah. Did anyone else just get really nervous? Like, I don't know what it is. Is like any like Invicta fight, UFC fight, like I'm fine. But as soon as the ladies fight, I get so nervous. And I don't know why. And I think it's just because like I expect like fireworks every time we fight.
I still like, I see them walk out. I start to like.
I imagine like, myself in their
yeah,
shoes.
Yeah, I like, do. I start to like get into walkout mode. No, Tina's good, man. She's a good actor.
I want her to act like this all the time.
Yeah. Valentina is such a good actor. Wow.
Look cool. Scared of her.
I love it because her intensity is like so real.
It is.
I love this.
You better get nominated for an Oscar.
It's like she's doing Valentina things just at like a higher intensity.
Right.
Yeah.
I get the goosebumps when good fights. I always say I'm warped in the brain because I get the goosebumps. You know, it's like really excited in that way.
I feel like I have like ants in my pants and like I'm like I can't like relax because I'm so excited right now.
You dance?
Oh, I love this stare down. I just want to fight now, man. This is
I love that they used her name, the Lady Killer, which is actually like a fight name, Lady Killer, which is Amanda Bell,
right?
Who has fought for Invicta. It was her fight name. Like yeah, it was her, which I thought that was a really cool touch as well.
I told you guys the story about how she was at the Invicta fights, like scouting, and she was in the cage. And I was like, I prepped for this show. Who is that woman? I don't know that fighter. Because Hallie was in the cage, you know, like with braids and stuff. And I was like, I don't recognize that fighter. And I don't know what's going on. I don't know who this is. It is Halle Berry.
You know, true story. She blended in so well that when she was downstairs in the athlete area, security went down three times, the police officer, and they're like, she's not here. I'm like, yeah, she is. You know, I mean, nobody recognized her, which was amazing.
I love it.
Killer. Oh! And that's my name.
Keith Peterson? Keith, no nonsense, Peterson? Let's go.
It smells like cigarettes and beer.
Oh, shit.
That sounds like me giving fighters shit.
Yeah. Julie, that like that right there, it's like you would say that in real life. I've heard you say that before.
I don't mean to, I'm not trying to be mean. I just get so into it. I just talk. Wait, why are we watching Hair?
Aww. Mm-mm. How weird is it hearing yourself in a movie, Julie?
Oh, I think I look ridiculous, but I love it. Like, how much fun is it? Like, I just, Eve was so fun to work with too. Like, he was cracking jokes the whole time. I wish they could have been half the jokes he was saying in there. He was so funny. Yeah. I was going to say, I don't know. I would want more technical advice in that, but the slap was good, actually. Look at me, like, analyzing it. That was a horrible shot, yeah. Oh, I love that I'm tense like it's a real fight.
That was nice.
Now get your hips down, girl. Come on. I like that I'm coaching now. Amber.
You know what's really weird? Seeing Valentina Shevchenko bleeding in a fight.
Yeah.
Like, it's just, it's unnatural.
I love her delivery, though. She looks so, I mean, I know it's movie punching, but it sounds like something I'd say, piss somebody off.
Shout out to Halle Berry. I'm pretty sure she's still getting messed up, even though this is just a movie. Like, those kicks, even just being placed. I've done some stunt work for Hawaii 5-0 where we had to do that, and I was, like, more busted than, like, a regular trainee.
Yeah, she broke her ribs in the filming.
She broke her ribs?
Yeah. Yeah.
Wow.
When I tell you she was all in, and this was passion, and this was... She was in. She wanted to tell the story and get as close, you know, as accurate as she could to represent the female athletes.
That's crazy. I didn't even know that.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, that's literally what I was telling Paulina right after. I'm like, dude, even fake shots, like, it's hitting, even though it's hitting her lightly with power like that, it's like, I'm sure her legs were bruised for, like, weeks after this.
And then you got to think about how many takes. I was there. There was
such a beautiful transition.
So it's constant, repeated hit after hit.
God, I love them. Then I'm gritting my teeth and I'm like coaching it now.
I was going to say, who was teaching them their technique? Like, who was the
stunt director?
The stunt director. Wow, that's great.
It's, you know, really realistic.
His name, but I know she did a lot of training in the gyms, like Tanisha's gym, you know, worked out with a lot of different trainers in the New York area, but I don't know. I can't remember.
I know Matan in New York. I forgot his last name. Darn it. I shouldn't have said anything, but yeah.
Nice. It's always nice to see the movies nowadays where their actual fight scenes are way more evolved because of the UFC and MMA.
Yeah.
I love
and
that.
They're bringing in like actual professionals to make it realistic as well.
Yeah. That's huge. One of the interviews that she did, she talked about how she felt that she was naturally gifted in the jiu-jitsu side. You know, that it just came natural to her and that she really enjoys it and gets into the flow.
She did capoeira, I think, for Catwoman. I think I read about that. I saw her in an interview talking about that. But it's just like, I feel like she's just so athletic. Like, it's incredible. I know they're doing big movements for the jiu-jitsu, but it just seems the technical aspect is, you know. Pull your shoulder blades back.
Oh, save by the bell.
I've been in this position a million times, I swear, where the time's like almost up and you're like, no.
Two more seconds.
When you are in that position, Rachel, what does it do to your confidence? I mean, does it ignite the fire? Does it kind of slow it down and just like, ugh?
I mean, of course, I feel like it's a little bit of a letdown. You're like so tired, giving it your all, knowing you can finish the fight and you run out of time. I mean, but just to being in that position is also, it's a fight.
Does it give you confidence going into that next round, knowing that like you've taken them there before, you can do it again?
Most definitely, yeah. You know, if exactly. Cool.
And then she doesn't get her hooks. Oh, there she does.
Like her jiu-jitsu transitions are really, really good. Like they're on point.
That's what I think really brings, you know, that validity to these scenes and makes it, a great scripted fight scene.
Oh, that was beautiful. Yeah.
Yeah.
Duration. This is cool. Yeah. Oh, Hallie kept in the Oma Plata line. We did that in ADR and one of the people told me not to use that line because they didn't know what it meant. And she said, no, keep it in there. It's technical. Of course, it didn't happen at the time it was happening, but. Oh, get out, Hallie. Oh, that's cool. That's smart.
Julie, you're so great.
No, I'm just like watching. I'm commentating now. I'm like, I don't remember this at all. Shit, this
is fun. I've sat next to Julie and her face is literally identical when she is calling every single fight. This is how much she gets into commentating every single event, every single fight. And it's so amazing to see on the screen.
Thank you. It's a little embarrassing, but I love it. I don't know how you could not. I think that's the only reason I still love MMA in a lot of ways, because I'm not fighting, but I get to experience it, not with you guys, but I get to, I don't know, I get to show what you're doing. Oh, that's cute. I mean, not cute, cool.
Oh.
Go that way. Allie. Gosh, she's flexible, man.
It looks good, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm. It really does.
I know.
Body triangle.
That happens so often in jiu-jitsu too. Like, oh no, she's about to go out.
No, she's not.
She's going off.
Nice.
Peter, someone's on the
I really like that they didn't make it a finish and it went to a decision. Like, I like that neither of them had to lose, like from like a stoppage, you know what I mean?
It really mirrors life too. It's like not neatly wrapped up in a bow. Like, it's
like, how many times have you been in this spot where it's,
hey, are they in though? It's just, yeah. Hope they have good judges.
That's hilarious.
I know, like if you're fighting in Mexico.
Ladies and gentlemen, having gone all five championship rounds here at Portland, Atlantic City, we now go to the scorecards. The judges scored this contest 48-47 Chavez.
Who you guys got?
Chavez? Is she like Latina?
47 for your winner. By split decision.
Well, I'm not getting all the feels. Oscar for Valentina. You know how long it took me to get these false eyelashes on? Now I'm going to cry them off.
We all need to. Is that, you know, women are strong, resilient, they're capable, you know, and that failures are just kind of stepping stones, that, success and winning looks different for everybody. Mm. You know, I hope if anybody takes anything away from this is that winning is getting up and getting in the fight. That's what it's about, you know, not being defined by your circumstances. And that's probably the one thing I hope this, you know, teaches, or, you know, if anybody walks away with anything, I hope the female athletes walk away with that lesson.
You didn't need me in that fight. I mean, I wish I'd chosen another way to prove it to you, because this shit fucking hurts. But you had it all in you. Oh, I said this shit. I'm gonna let you get this thing off. I'm gonna let you get this thing off. You believe what I'm saying? I got this to knock it off.
how you want. Just say one word.
That hurts. Don't do that.
I'm okay. Meg is okay.
Whose idea was this?
Rachel, I'm going to ask you the first question. As a mom who had goes through, you've been through this, you live this, how close to home does this movie come for you?
Oh, it's like right in my house, close to home, you know? I've related to this movie so much. And I'm like so grateful to be part of this watch party and yeah, part of Invicta and have this. Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry.
But yeah,
I loved it. I love this movie, and I love how it shows like the real life at home life. How you said like there's sometimes it's not about the fight. It's like the fight is, you know, the months leading up to it, and we've all experienced that on very deep levels. I'm really glad she captured all of that. And not
like this has to be an incredible moment for you.
Well, healing, you know, and I think it really sends once again that message through, like I was saying before, is that, you know, winning is getting up and getting in the fight, you know, and changing the circumstance, not letting it define who you are. And, you know, Rachel, I've seen you do that with your life, your career, pick it up and put it together. And, you know, so, you know, I commend you for that 100%.
Thank you.
Really have done some great things. You know, it's just, you know, this movie, like I said, the biggest thing for me would be is that, you know, the athletes take away that, you know, you get up, you get moving, and this is winning, you know, that is winning. And I've always said this about ever since I started Invicta, it's that these women have been fighting just to get the opportunity to fight. So that's what I've always believed, that the fight really happens all the way up. You know, the end part is just stepping in the cage. That's just a, you know, a part of it. But the real battle begins when you're getting, you know, in that preparation and then just in life.
Well, fight fans at home, we're going to be opening up a bit of a Q&A here at the end of the movie now. I'm going to start off with asking a couple of the girls some questions, but you guys feel free to put some questions in the chat and I'll ask them as well. First one I want to ask is Julie. Julie, you've made history in your own right as a martial artist fighting Gina Carano back in the day. Like, how incredible, you've been there essentially from the start. Like, how incredible is it for you to see the evolution of women's MMA and culminate, like, we now have a movie dedicated to women in martial arts. Like, how incredible is it for you to have watched the progression over this, over the years?
I mean, it's everything. I'm gonna lose my shit right now. Especially Rachel just set me off, but I'm gonna get together. Okay, it's everything. And I think what was really captured in this movie that I used to joke a lot about being famous for losing, because all of those big fights, the Carano fight, Tate fight, you know, the ones that were the big deal televised fights, I lost. And I didn't feel like I was less of a person for having lost them. I felt like I was in something bigger than me. But I also knew that it wasn't just me. Like, of course, the winner gets the accolades, they get all this. But just seeing the quiet redemption that happens there, it's like, yeah, you don't get it, because even if you lost that fight, and it may take a while, but as a fighter, even if you've lost on some of the biggest stages or you've lost those career defining moments, it's not a life defining moment. You're actually a better person for having just fucking done it. And I swear to God, well, every single one of the athletes could kick my ass now for where I was right there. And then it's just like, when I see people coming up now, I love, it sounds so egotistical, but I love to hear that they don't know who I am, the younger athletes. I mean, it's like I was anybody, but I was in those career defining losses or whatever, those moments, but because they don't have to deal with that same shit, because right, it's yeah, been paved for them, because Shannon's created this platform, because this movie's out there, like they're in the UFC. Not every weight class would need to fix that. And it's not the UFC anymore. That's not the biggest game in town. But the fact that we can say that it's not going to be the biggest game in town, that it's, there's so much more and there's so many more opportunities. It's, you don't expect to see that happen in your lifetime. But I just like, yeah. Anyway, I don't think I said a coherent statement there, but yeah. I think that movie meant a lot. That meant a fucking lot. Yeah.
Juliana and Paulina, I want to pose this next question to you. What do you guys think of the fight scenes? Do you think it was realistic? Do you think it was believable? Like, how do you guys, did you think it, they were amazing? Like, what were you guys' thoughts on the fight scenes? And really just the training in general, is, did you see stuff that you guys do in your own training in the movie? Like, was it realistic?
I thought it was pretty realistic, except for like one little thing I noticed, which is, and it's when she like kind of like jumped guard, she kind of like passed the guard and like kind of jumped in the mount.
Yeah.
Like, oh, yep. That's so easy. I don't see anybody really doing that to Shevchenko. But other than that, it also like looked pretty good, like the transitions and just like watching her flow and like how she's kind of like floating around and stuff in the ground. Like, it was cool to watch that part of the fight and like, you know, because she was like more like of a grappler and you could definitely see it in those scenes. That was pretty cool to watch. And I honestly, though, like when those scenes were happening, I was like thinking about her, because she's like, she's the grappler. And it's like what Jackie Justice was doing is usually like when Juliana goes through a fight. So like, I was like, oh shit, it's kind of like what happens to Juliana when she fights. So I thought it was pretty cool to watch. And I was kind of like thinking about that as I was watching it. So
I loved watching her jujitsu. Honestly, some of the jujitsu she was doing in there was so advanced. It takes years to teach most people. Like, I mean, she went for a guillotine. Normally, like, if I'm gonna flip someone over my head, I use a Kimura grip just because it's like, it's really tight. She went for something really advanced. She attacked the guillotine when Valentina brought her hands up. She brought an underhook, then butterflied her leg and flipped her over. Like that whole movement right there is not simple to learn. And it's like, I was just so excited to see her level of jujitsu. And she did one thing so beautiful. She went, it was actually, she was pounding on the rev gear bag and she did these hip switches to mount. And the way she switched her hips, like a hip switch is such an important thing for jujitsu and passing guard. And it's the hardest for beginners to get is like you're here, then you're here, then you're here. And like the how fluid her hips were switching. In my mind, I'm like, oh my God, that was a beautiful hip switch. Like, that's a very hard movement. I've taught kids classes. I've taught women's self-defense seminars. And like learning how to rotate your hips into a good position is so difficult. And she made it look like she was cutting through butter. And so like, that was really beautiful. Like I loved watching her jujitsu. I'm like, I hope I can roll with her like just lightly one day. And I'm like, man, you could beat me up too. That'd be
fun. Tanisha, like being the current Invicta Bantamweight champion, how do you think a movie like this will impact Invicta and bringing more awareness to the sport and particularly being a champion yourself? Like, do you think that this could be huge, bringing more eyes and more, I guess, knowledge about women's MMA and Invicta and giving you ladies more of a spotlight?
Yeah, definitely. The people who are already in martial arts, they know about Invicta and everything, but having a mainstream movie, it was in theaters and also on Netflix, it definitely broadened people's eyes onto the movie and into the Invicta organization. So, I mean, I think a lot more people will be more interested in Invicta now. So it's good.
Shannon, I've got a question for you. How hard was it to start an all women's MMA promotion?
Back when I started, I can remember talking to, and I've been on the male side of the sport for many years. And I remember talking to some of my colleagues and saying, hey, this is what I'm going to do. And they would laugh at me a little bit and be like, what? Are you kind of crazy? And then I remember the time too, when I talked to Dana and I said, Dana, this is what I'm going to do. And I said, I'm going to start this promotion. It's going to be all women. He's like, I love it. You got big balls, Shannon. That was the reaction. I knew it wasn't going to be an easy task, but it was going to be a passion project. And, every time that I see somebody stepping closer to a dream or something like that, it really makes all those struggles worth it. It really does. That's why we do it. And it's not just me. I've surrounded myself with a team that has that same passion and same drive. Every position that's in the company or everybody that works on these events, we all want the same thing. It's not about us. It's not about, the dollar. You have to keep the lights on. But it's really about helping each and every athlete accomplish that dream.
Julie, I know you've been around Invicta for a long time. How weird was it seeing a guy play Shannon Roll in the movie?
They had nice jewelry.
You need to get one of those.
Should have been Shannon. Oh, wing it. That should have been Shannon. I'm not a casting director, but I would have cast Shannon 100%. Yeah.
But in all fairness, I will say that when I came on the scene, the movie was already cast. It was already, everybody was filled and things like that. But wouldn't you expect it to be a man though? Come on, seriously. It didn't surprise me by any means. It just goes to show we need to do more work, right?
Now she's got to do a bruise. Oh, wait. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Now she's got to do a bruise too, and show Shannon.
Yeah, I'll come in and take out.
Yeah. Sure. Bring it to new heights. Rachel, I'm going to ask you this question. Rachel, I'm going to ask you this question. How well do you think the movie represented women's MMA? And did you feel like it was, I know you mentioned earlier that it came really close to home. Do you feel like it really depicted real life?
I mean, you know, I can't speak for everyone. I know we all have different stories and situations that arise, but you know, for me, I definitely related to it. I felt like I loved how they kept it real. You know, it wasn't, you know, rainbows and butterflies. It was very realistic, down to, you know, the point where the kid is peeing his, her son is peeing his pants, and she's late for practice. And like, you know, like that kind of stuff always happens to me. And I'm just like, you know, you just can't win sometimes. And it, you know, it just feels like that. And I love that they really, they kept it real. And even where she didn't even win at the end, but she did win self-respect. She won her son's, you know, love and forgiveness. And like that right there is the win, you know? So it's just, yeah, I loved it.
I think it was a really good depiction of like, I think people don't realize that it's the journey getting to the fight, which is the hard part, which is the struggle, which is you got to face your demons. You get being a mom or working four or five jobs, or you can't pay for this or you can't pay for that. You got to pay for training. You got to be on time, or like you had a shit practice, your weight cut's going wrong. Like I think it really did a phenomenal job of showcasing everything. The everyday life.
Relationships.
Of, yes. You know. Like everything that kind of culminates behind the scenes that nobody really talks about. And particularly for a woman, it's 10 times worth. Like for the most part, like I know I can't speak for everybody else in the panel, but I know myself being a featherweight, I'm a bigger girl. I don't train with females. All I've trained for my entire career is with males, and predominantly males who are much heavier than I am, like 170, 180, up to 200 pounds. And so like people don't, I think, really see those behind the scenes of like the how draining it is day in, day out, and then having to deal with everything on top of else. And I think like, and I'll pose this question to everyone, how did you guys take it? Because the tone of the movie was very dark. It was very morbid. It was very sad. But I feel like that was kind of necessary because that's what fight camps are like. Like they're not all rainbows and sunshines, and you have your good days, you have your bad days. But I think for the most part, there's a lot of self-doubt and there's a lot of working through those issues. And like, how did each of you kind of, did you think that that was the right kind of vibe for the movie? Like, I'll start with you, Shannon. Do you think that that was, you know, the trend that it needed to be to kind of really get the point across?
Yeah, I think definitely, you know, that's where they wanted to take it. And I think it certainly fits, you know, with the storyline. And, you know, in the end, that message, you know, winning is, you know, being in the fight, and, you know, she took her life back. And I think sometimes when you look at those kind of messages and from the darkness, what comes to the light at the end, I think this played out the way it should have been for what they wanted, the story they wanted to tell.
And Shannon, Julia, I'm going to bring it to you next. There was a lot of triggering events in this movie that I'm going to say a lot of us have probably experienced at some point or other in our life. How close to home was that for you?
Oh, I mean, it's so funny because like you said, a lot of us experienced them before. I don't think I would be hard pressed to find a fighter who hasn't dealt with confusing relationships when it comes to fights and boundaries being crossed that shouldn't be crossed, and even elements of abuse. I mean, they were extremely strong in this movie, you know, with her partner and stuff. But I feel like it's unfortunate because I think MMA is so beautiful. And I think that there was such an incredible story being told here, but I don't think it would have been a true story without those triggering moments. I don't think it would have been true to MMA. And I'm not shitting on the sport by any means. It's my passion. I'm a lifer, even if I'm not fighting. But I think the struggle that every single athlete has to go through is incredibly real. And it is not the healthiest life, but it's also the healthiest life in a lot of ways. It's not a pretty story to be a professional fighter, but I don't think there's anything else like it in the world. It's unparalleled. And I think that's something that she captured there. Yeah.
I'm going to pose this question to Juliana. I don't know if you've seen this movie. It's called Whip It. It's about roller derby. Do you expect to see like meaningful jumps in viewers for Invicta coming out of this movie? Is that something that you guys kind of see happening? And how do you think that that will affect you guys as current athletes?
More than I think viewers, I think all the women that love Valentina and Halle Berry are going to watch this and get themselves into some form of training. Of course it will bring eyes to Invicta, but I think more than anything, we're going to see an even higher spark in women's martial arts. And, you know, I started with Liz Carmouche and Lima Leigh McFarlane. And one thing Liz would talk about is she's like, there wasn't really girls to fight. It was a thing where like, man, you fought the same people multiple times around a ring of circle because there wasn't that many women. And as time goes on, it's like, even as a beginning professional, the level is just rising so fast. So it's like, I think that a ton more women are just going to want to get in there and fight. Honestly, as Shannon, for you, I think you're going to have a lot of people reaching out like, let me fight for Invicta. Yeah, like I think everyone's just going to want to fight. I think we're going to see a spark in the combative sport and that drive and desire to win.
I'm going to pose this question to Tanisha. What did you think of the soundtrack of the movie? I know we kind of mentioned during it that it was made history as like the first female rap album or first female soundtrack for a movie or something like that. Like, do you feel like it really did it justice?
Yeah, I think so. I definitely enjoyed it. I was listening to a few songs on the soundtrack outside of the movie, and I enjoyed it. Young M.A., that was another one that I enjoyed, but yeah.
Cool. Rachel, if you were the character Jackie Justice, because I know this one you relate very closely, being a mom in your own right, and with the experience that you have in the sport, is there anything that you would have done differently?
Can't say that I don't regret a couple of things, but I am grateful how everything played out. I know I needed to learn a lot of lessons. And so I can't really say that. I don't know. Yeah, I think, yeah, there would be things I would do differently. If I had the opportunity, why not? like toxic relationships, that was a big one that really messes with you going into fights. And I felt like that those emotions really influenced my record and my fight nights and all of that. But
I feel
you know
that.
you gotta go through it, you know. And I'm so glad that I did go through everything that I went through. And like you said, like even like I've learned so much more from losing, and I've won that, and I carry that with me. And if I didn't have that, I would definitely not be the person I am today. And I'm nowhere near perfect. I'm still fighting. I'm still learning with every fight and every day. And I think that's just life, and I'm grateful to have that.
I'm going to pose this question to everyone, so I'm going to go around and ask you all, but what was your favorite part of the movie? Julie, I'm going to start with you.
I mean, me, but no. but I think I loved Valentina, but the movie theater scene, like when she turns and looks at her son and he kind of looks back at the movie and she's just staring at him, blew me away. Halle Berry is a really good actor. She's a really good director. Like, is that those quiet moments when you're looking at somebody and you're seeing them be themselves And like, you just, I don't know, that took me to a different level. So that was amazing. Yeah.
Paulina, I'm going to ask you the same question. Paulina, same question for you. You're muted.
My favorite moment in the movie was actually the part where she lost and she came back when they were like, Jackie or Justice, whatever they're saying, when they're chanting her name, she came back. And I really liked that moment because during my losses, like when I feel like a fucking loser and I'm like, oh, like I suck, like what she felt in that moment with like the fans chanting her, like I've actually felt that with my like fan base. When I feel like really down, they just like uplift me so much. And like, I don't know why, like when she did that in the movie, like when she came back and like, I felt like I could feel what she was feeling in that moment. So I really like that. And also I like the part where she tied the little boy's shoes and he's like, thank you, babe. Ah, that part got me. I was like, I love to cry. So like, I love that part. That part was awesome.
I'm going to move on to Tanisha. Same question for you.
My favorite part was, I think, the sparring scene. Not just because like I personally knew a lot of people in the scene, but there's nothing better than just sparring and working on your skills. So that's my favorite part.
Juliana?
Like the most touching moment for me was when she was walking with her son and the music came on the bump box, the little stereo, and it was the dad's song. And for anyone that's lost somebody that they love a lot, like in any point in life, music is a huge reminder of them. And when somebody's going through that depth of a pain, like loss of a loved one, there's nothing you can do to make them feel better besides just be there with them. She didn't try to say, hey, it's okay, it's okay. She didn't try to comfort him. She just let him have a moment of like breaking before feeling the love. And with such an intense loss, I haven't lost my dad, but like this year, 4 people very close to me have died, and certain things remind me of them throughout my daily life. And I don't want somebody to tell me it's okay. Sometimes it's not okay. I just want to be able to feel it in the moment. And I loved that moment where it was okay for him to be broken and crying, and it was okay for her to be broken and crying. And instead of just like changing it to be something different, or that it's gonna be okay, or that what happened was okay, together they just like had this feeling of loss and brokenness, and then, you know, like let it go and moved on past it and worked onto something stronger. And I was like, oh my gosh, that part touched me so deep.
Shannon, I'm gonna ask you the same question. What was your favorite part? I know this isn't the first time you've seen it. I know you were at the premiere. So even watching it a couple times now, like, is there one particular scene that stands out for you?
I like the end of the show when she's with her son and, you know, he's holding her hand and he speaks and they don't know where they're going, but the message is, you know, we've got each other and I'm living now. Essentially, to me, that's what it says, is that she's taken her life back and, you know, her son, she's committed to doing, you know, raising him. It's just a great moment. It's a good ending. You know, it's a heartfelt good ending.
And Rachel, last one, what was your favorite part?
Of course, that was my favorite part too, but I did like, I liked the scenes where she was just like, the one where she walked back into the gym and the coach was like, why are you here? You know, and it's like, she didn't really answer. She just was like, just got to work, you know? And that part, I felt like we all have been there, like after, or like, well, I've been there, like after a fight camp. I mean, after like you win a fight, you take some time off and you like get back in the gym and you're like, oh, okay, like, let's do this again. And then I think the other part I really liked was, where was he the boyfriend or the ex-manager boyfriend, abusive guy? He came back and the kitchen was clean. And it just shows, like, you know, the change that she realized, like, I gotta get my shit together, you know, like, I have a kid now depending on me. And, like, you know, it's almost like we need our kids as much as they need us. I mean, it is that for me as well. And it was nice to see that in the movie. Yeah.
Well, thank you to everyone for coming and hanging out with us for the Bruised Invicta watch along. You can check out Bruised on Netflix. Also, the soundtrack is streaming everywhere. Invicta will be back in January. Make sure to follow all of the socials to keep up to date on all of the announcements that will be coming, hopefully soon. Fingers crossed, Shannon. But guys, thank you so much for coming and joining with us. Thank you to Shannon, Julie, Tanisha, Paulina, Julia, Rachel. Thank you all of you for coming and hanging with us for a couple hours and doing this watch party. I hope you all have a great evening. Have a happy Thanksgiving to everyone tomorrow, and make sure to go watch Bruised again.